Raster slopes can be measured in two ways, by using the slope angle or by using the slope aspect. In FME, slope angle is measured with the raster slope calculator, and the slope aspect is measured with the raster aspect calculator. In this tutorial, we will use both of these transformers to see what they do. Let's open FME Workbench and begin with an empty canvas. Add a reader and set the data format to Canadian Digital Elevation Data, or CDED for short. Use the attached dataset found on the corresponding FME Knowledge Base tutorial. Place a raster aspect calculator and a raster slope calculator on the canvas. Draw a connection from the reader to each of the transformers. Connect the output from each transformer to an inspector. Go ahead and run the workspace. The result will be two raster features that appear in the FME data inspector. One raster surface representing slope and the other representing aspect. Let's select the slope layer. Query the raster cells on the slope surface by clicking on them. Each cell represents the slope at that location. The areas with brighter spots have a steeper slope. The value of the slope for each cell location is displayed in the feature information panel. Now let's select the aspect layer. Query the rasters again. Notice that each cell represents the direction of the slope at that location, from 0 to 360 degrees. FME doesn't visualize this very well, so let's improve how slope aspect is displayed by modifying the raster surface using the Raster Expression Evaluator Transformer. Let's return to our previous workspace and place a Raster Expression Evaluator on the canvas. Open its Parameters dialog, set Interpretation to Preserve. Double-click the Expression field, open the Arithmetic Editor. We will enter an expression to calculate the slope aspect results from 0 to 180, both clockwise and counterclockwise. This will greatly improve the display. The expression is included on the tutorial webpage. Disable the raster slope calculator connection and run the workspace. The newly calculated raster aspect surface will be displayed in the FME Data Inspector. Notice how the coloring is now more consistent, making it easier to see the dark areas that face north. Our next exercise will use raster data and the raster slope calculator to calculate the suitability of land for development. A building development usually prefers land that is both flat and low-lying. Let's run a quick analysis to find the best areas for future development. Start FME Workbench and begin with an empty canvas. Add a reader for CDED and select the dataset. Place a raster slope calculator into the workspace and draw a connection from the reader to the transformer. Next, place a raster cell value calculator. Notice how this transformer has both an A and B input port. Connect the raster slope calculator output port to the raster cell value calculator B input port. Draw a second connection from the reader to the raster cell value calculator A input port. Open the parameters dialog for the raster cell value calculator. Simply change the operation parameter to the plus option. This will add the original data, representing elevation, to the transform data, representing slope. Let's run the workspace. The result will be areas for building development. Notice how lighter colors represent cells that have both a steep slope and a higher elevation. Darker colors are cells that have both a shallow slope and a low elevation. For the purposes of our example, darker colored cells would be good candidates for building development.